Hello friends, welcome to VTutorial. I am Mahavir. Today I will explain all the tips and tricks and the best practice for entering the data in Excel. That include the moving tricks. Friends, we normally use the Excel for entering the data. There is many methods in which we can enter the data. We can also move the data by cut, copy, paste, or we move the cursor by clicking in any cell. There's so many tips. But I will teach you the best practices which will help you to increase your speed to entering the data and managing your data in efficient way. I've been working on Excel almost for 15 years and I rarely use the mouse for working on Excel because it takes time. It is very important to enter the data in better way. It will save our time and increase our productivity. So dear friends, let us start. I always suggest the users, please try not to use the mouse whenever you work in the Excel because it takes time and time is very precious, you know that. I always try to remember the shortcut keys and the new methods. So I'm sharing with you. This video is very important. Please take care. Dear friends, whenever you are in the Excel and you want to go to the first cell, shortcut key is press Ctrl Home. You will be on cell A1. You may be aware that this is the cell A1. How we know the cell number is column name and the row number. So it is column A and the row number is 1. So it is cell number A1. So whenever you press Ctrl plus Home, it always come there. This is the first trick. Now we will start entering our data. For example, we want to make the employees list of our company. So first we need to enter the heading. So the heading would be the table heading. I mean to say the heading would be serial number. And now I will not use the mouse anymore. Then I will normally, we will use the right arrow key and then we will type the name, then we will press right arrow key again, last name, then again right arrow key, then mobile number or whatever you want to enter, then we will press enter to get down. So dear friend, you have noticed that whenever we press the enter, it will come one cell down, but I need to enter the data in that table, so I will press the home button here, not with the control key, only I will press the home key. So I will come there, home, and now I will start entering the data of that particular table. The serial number would be 1, so I will press 1. Now I can select two keys here for moving right side. Either I can press the right arrow button or I can press the tab. So this time I will use the tab key. I will press the tab. Now it is moving to the one cell right hand side. Now I will type the name John. Again I will press the tab. Carrie. Then I will press the tab. I will enter the mobile number. And now I will press the enter to get next row. Dear friend, you have noticed that now the cursor is on A3. It means there is no need to press home button or the left arrow key to come to the first cell to enter the data. It comes automatically on the data where I want to start again. This is the first tip. Always use tab button whenever you want to enter the data in a table. Just now I give the demo to you. Dear friends, now I want to come to the heading section. So I will press Ctrl Home. Now I want to select the heading. Press the Shift key, then press right arrow key 1 time, 2 time, 3 time. So by that way, we can select the number of cells or the area which we want. But friend, this is the one way. Now I will tell you the shortcut key for that. So you can select the whole row. Press home button. Now if you want to highlight the whole whole row. So you can press shift space, so you can select the same row and you can do your formatting if you want to do the formatting for the whole row. So we can bold it by pressing Ctrl B, Ctrl I for italic, Ctrl U for underline. This is normal. Now we want to fill the color, but not that complete row, only the heading one. So, and we want to also align that particular row. So for that, I can use the mouse. I can simply click on the alignment center and I can come here and click on that. But I told you before, we will not use the mouse anymore. Dear friend, now you can see the alignment group in the center tool is available on the home tab. So how we will go to the home tab and that particular tool which you want to use? Press Alt tab. Now you can see the letters on the tab. The file, for the file tab it is F, for home tab it is H, N, P, M, A, and so on. Or we want to go to the home tab, so this time we will press H. And this is not the combination keys. First we pressed Alt key, then we will press the H. Now we can see the letters for particular tool. We want to align center, so the shortcut key, or you can say the letter, is AC. So we will press A and C. So now we used the center key. This is the best practice. So now what is the you can say the combination? No, it is not the combination. We can see we can say it is the sequence of the commands. So it is Alt H A C. So when I remember that, because I normally use that command, I used maybe 100 times in a day, so we can use that way. So it will take very less time whenever you use any command. Now we want to fill the color, so we will go to the same way, but this time we don't want to fill the color on the whole row. We want to select on the first four cells. So press home, and this time we want to select that field data in a single way. So press shift, then press end, and then this time we will press the right arrow key button. Now you can see in a three press we got our area selected. Maybe you are thinking it is taking time right now, but once you will be familiar with these commands, it will take very less time. Now we will fill the colors. So we will press the Alt H, and this time also H. Now you can see the all colors. So how we will select the colors? Now you can press the you can use the arrow keys like that. You can use the mouse here if you want, and I think this color is good. Press enter. Now color is filled. Like that you can select that particular data, or you can use the commands. Okay friends, now I want to move that data. The header is completely selected. Now I want to select that second row as well. So this time I will press the shift and then down right key and Control X for cut. Now I will move that data and I will come to that particular place where I want to put that data, and I will press Control plus V. Now data has been moved. Dear friends, now I will use the mouse button. Why? Let me tell you one thing. For example, I want to put any data in particular cells. In the particular cells, the data would be same. It can be a date, it can be the name or the letter, particular things. So you select the particular area. For example, here I want to enter the name or ABC, whatever. Select the area, type the letter or the number where you want to enter. Okay, I will entering the date. So 1st January 2016. And now press Control Enter. Data has been filled all selected cells. So this is very good shortcut key for filling the data. I normally use that thing. This selection in sequence, so it maybe happen I want to enter here, then press Control here and keep press that Control key, then click on the cells where you want to enter the same data. It means we are selecting that particular cells. Now entering the data whatever you want to enter. So in this case also I will enter the date, but this time it would be 31st of December 2016. Now press Control and Enter. See the magic? And now you can use any command like Alt H. You can fill the color. Again press H, select the color of your choice, press Enter. So this is the shortcut key commands. Now I want to come on first cell, press Control Home. It comes there. Now you can move the cursor by pressing down arrow key. Move down arrow key. Now friend, we will use End and Home button. I will press End key from the keyboard and I will use right arrow key. It comes to the first filled cell. Now I will press Home. It will come to the last column, but in the same row. But once you select the Control Home, it will come to the cell A1. Now dear friends, I want to move. Again I will select the End button and I will press down arrow key. It will come to the end of the column, because in the particular column there is no cell filled. If there is a cell in which there is some data, it will stop there. So now I will press Control Home. It will come to that point. We can check here. We can move by pressing right arrow key 2 times. We will come to the C1 cell. Now again I will press the End and down arrow key. You can see it comes directly to the filled cell, first filled cell. Again I will press End button and right arrow key. It comes to the, now dear friends, select that particular table. Now my task is I want to select the unfilled cells. Now I will click on the find and select. But dear friend, I told you in the beginning I will not use the mouse. So I will continue on that task. So I will press Alt H F. Sorry, I pressed wrong way. Press Escape button. Whenever you pressed any wrong thing, press Escape. You will be back. Now press FD. Now select Go to Spatial S. And now press, or you can move the selection by down arrow key. We want to come blanks and press Enter. Now you're in the particular selection. Which cell is blank, that would be selected. Now you can enter the data or you can highlight it by entering the color. So I will enter the color. So I will come to Alt H, again H, and this time it would be dark red. So these were the some tips you can use in your daily routine that would really help to increase your efficiency and effectiveness. I hope guys you would like that video. Please subscribe my channel to get the latest updates from my channel whenever we upload any video. You can visit our Facebook page. You can see the link of the Facebook page in the description field. Thank you for watching the video. Please come back for new videos and learnings.